By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, all the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Of the 1995 SportsCare Louisiana Coaches Awards. Representing SportsCare at midfield, SportsCare representative Mike McKeough and Keith Patterson. The first award, the 1995 SportsCare Award, presented by Mike McKeough, goes to Cecilia head coach Jimmy Wagerspack. And the next 1995 SportsCare Coaches Award, presented by Keith Patterson of SportsCare of Louisiana, goes to Edna Carr head coach John Wattingney. The Louisiana High School Athletic Association thanks SportsCare of Louisiana for providing the 1995 SportsCare Coaches Award.
Superdome for the Class 3A state championship between the undefeated Carr Cougars, ranked number one in the state of Louisiana, and the undefeated Cecilia Bulldogs, ranked number two in the state of Louisiana. It's LHSAA football here in the Superdome. Hello once again, everybody. I'm Gerald Duhon, along with Renee Nato, and tonight we bring you a stellar matchup that's a rematch of a ball game that was played on this turf just two short years ago, ended in an overtime victory. Cecilia hoping to avenge for that loss tonight, Renee, and they've got some of the talent to do it.
Yeah, you got two teams that are undefeated at 14-0. You got a couple of players you may want to watch for. Corey Jackson, number 24, versus Celia. He plays offense and defense. He's good enough to make all district on offense and defense. You'll see a lot of number 24 this evening.
For the Carr Cougars, excellence has been their program thus far. Only in the fourth year of varsity play, this is their second trip to the state finals. And really, it's a first-year player playing only his first year of organized football, and that's Noel Ellis. He's one of the keys both offensively and defense for Carr.
Yes, he was a basketball player prior to the 1995 season. He's got 14 interceptions on the season, so he's quite a talent. He's going to make a lot of visits. He's going to make someone an excellent safety on the next level on Saturday evening.
Well, this is how they draw it up. One against two. You vote them like that during the regular season. They're almost ready to get underway. It'll be Don Watney against James Wagerspack. It'll be Carr against Cecilia here from the Louisiana Superdome for the AAA state championship for the state of Louisiana. A fine crowd on hand has made the trip down from Acadiana and St. Martinville and the surrounding areas around Cecilia, right on the outskirts of the Lafayette area. And I might as well say on the front end, Renee, yes, my family is from the Lafayette area. No one in the New Orleans area can say Duyon, So we say Duhon here, so I know I'm pronouncing it incorrectly for those of you in the Cecilia area, but we'll go with Duhon here in New Orleans today. And Carr will receive the opening kickoff from Cecilia to start tonight's action. Carr dressed in their white jerseys with purple pants, purple numbers, and gold helmets with the purple Cougar Claw on it for the Cecilia Bulldogs. Gold helmets with the green numerals on the helmet, green jerseys, green trousers, and white numerals. And we are almost ready to get underway. Chris Broussard set to kick off this AAA state championship game. Jerry Phillips is deep for the Carr Cougars. And we are underway. A high end over end kick that Phillips will gather in at his own 10. He's got a nice wall in front of him. Makes the move at the 30. Dances out of one tackle. Look at him motor almost up to the 40-yard line. The Cougars will be in excellent shape to put in play first and 10, their first offensive possession here this evening. And Phillips. Phillips is a guy. The Cecilia offense is on the bench right now, getting ready to come out. The Carr offense is on the field. We'll check their starting lineup in just a moment, as Carr will put it in play first and 10 from their own 40-yard line. Edward Sims is his quarterback, the senior, 6'2", 185. Single wide receiver on the left, single on the right, split backfield behind Sims. Hand off to the right back, Drew. That was Corey Harrison, who primarily used in a short yardage situation for the Carr Cougars. He's dropped for a 2-yard loss. It'll be second down and 12. Credit Cornell Davis for that bone-crushing tackle. Hey,
Cornell Davis is a guy you got to watch out for. He's a junior, 6'2", 225, an all-district performer. He's that pass rush specialist, 4.8 speed. You see a lot of number 40 before this evening's over.
Second and 12. Double tight end formation. Sims wants the pass. Tosses the ball. It's complete. His first completion of the AAA state championship game. Rolling all the way down to the 40-yard line of Cecilia. A 21-yard pickup. Good enough for a first down.
And that was Robert Royal. Robert Royal was his receiver.
Let's check that Carr offensive board. Henry Brady's your tight end. Rima Washington, Bernard Robertson, Reuben Johnson, Marcus Levingston, Jeff Roach are your offensive line. Joe Walker, Don Brewer, Edward Sims, Corey Gibbons, and Leonard Welch, the running back. Double tight end formation again for Carr. Running formation. Sims keeps it on the option. He'll churn towards upfield on the far sideline, stay in bounds, and turn out a quick five before Jerome Wilkes, the middle inside linebacker for the Cecilia Bulldogs, makes the stop.
We look at Sims right there. Sims is quite an athlete. He can run a pass. He takes control. He's really taking control of the playoffs. Excellent reads. His second year as a starter, he's a little better on the run than he is on the pass, but what a talent he is. Ed Sims, a 6'2", 190-pound senior, he has the ability to probably play at the next level.
Quick count, quick snap, quick handoff. Going right into the line is Corey Harrison. We see a lot of action with him tonight. Leonard Welch, your normal starting halfback, is battling an ankle injury. Let's check the Cecilia defense. Carnell Davis, John Baptiste, Ernest Broussard, and Theo Singleton across the front line. Corey Green, Jerome Welch, one of their outstanding linebackers. Dewanis Richard, Chris Broussard, and Andre Chance. Israel Singleton and Corey Jackson rounding out your secondary for the 14-0 Cecilia Bulldogs. Third down and four. Flags stop this play before it can get underway. And we'll read it.
Looks like Henry Brady, the blocking tight end, may have jumped prematurely. He's the blocking tight end. Robert Royal caught the first pass. Is the receiving tight end. It goes against the Carr Cougars, and they will step it off 5 yards. And they're first penalty of the contest.
Ball start on the right.
They'll set up a third down and nine for the Carr offense. They're moving with the opening possession of this ball game for this AAA state championship. A rematch of the 1993 state championship. Sims keeps the ball on the option, eludes one tackle, but not the second pounding tackle of Jerome Wilson, Corey Green, the strong-sided middle linebacker coming in to make that hit. And it'll be fourth down around the 37-yard line. It'll be well short of the first down. Flag on the far side. We'll read it.
And Sims, with 401 yards rushing, he tries to turn it up, and he's turned back by Green and Wiltz. Stopped for a very short game, but it's a question on the play.
The call will be against the Carr Cougars.
Good look at Coach Don Watney. He's done an outstanding job. He's working on a second state championship in 3 years.
Coach Don, 49-9 in his four-year tenure.
Personal foul on the white, fourth down.
49-9 in his 4 years as a varsity coach at Carr. Of course, this program, much success in the New Orleans area on a junior high level. Now they'll be quitting that success to their varsity program. You heard the call, and it's a personal foul. It forced Carr into a punting situation. Low snap. The Carr punter, Jason Helmstetter, has to rush the ball. It'll bound around the 35-yard line.
Not a good kick.
A 15-yard punt by Helmstetter, and Renee, you can see the pressure, a low snap, and he just barely gets it off.
Yeah, he dropped the ball. He's lucky he got it off at all. The pressure was there. And puts the city in a good situation as they start the initial possession of this AAA championship here, the nightcap in the doubleheader here this evening.
Rusty Bayard bringing his offense beneath center, handoff, surging his way through his fullback Jermaine Davis across the 40, up to the 41, up to the 42. Therefore, he's finally stopped right there.
Jermaine Davis, he's that fullback. He's got 823 yards on the season, 10 of them going for scores, 173 carries, 10 of them going for scores. He averages 4.7 yards a tote. He's a blocker, but he gets the tough yards, which he just showed. He can get that tough running inside.
Pitt, Dupree, Chevalier, Landry, Green, and Alamar. The offensive line for Cecilia. Bayard on second down. Hit, the ball is loose. Back at the 30, man scramble for it. Let's see who comes up with it. Cecilia. Bayard blindsided as he dropped back into the pocket. And that's the Carr defense we'll be talking about all night long. That's the tough part of this unit. They pride themselves on their D, averaging 6 points given up per game so far in this 1995 campaign. Big loss on the play. It'll be third down and long. Wow.
And he was really hit from the blind side. As you can see, that was Jimmy Ferguson coming from the outside linebacker position, 4-7 speed, and boy, he really put the hat on the quarterback, Rusty Bayard.
Third and 17 officially. Double wide out to right-hand side. Bayard will look that way. Drops. Throws over the middle, intercepted by Jerry Phillips. Right around midfield, he dances out of one tackle. Down to the 45, far sideline. One man to beat, he may go. Turns it inside. Look at him turn his way for the end zone, and it's a Carr touchdown. Jerry Phillips in the defense. A 53-yard interception return for a touchdown, and they're partying in Algiers here early in the Louisiana Superdome.
Jerry Phillips called by many the best athlete on the team, loaded with good athletes. In fact, this Carr defense, or this Carr team, has 10 college prospect seniors. Jerry Phillips, with 4-5 speed, picks off a pass. Bayard drops back, and Phillips just red his eyes, steps right for his overthrow, actually. But he gets some good blocks, gets some help. Watch a good block coming right here. That was Shannon Smith playing a good block for him, and Jerry Phillips knows what to do with the ball tucked over his arm. He plays offense on occasion, and Phillips, with good moves in the open field into the end zone, puts the Carr Cougars on it. So it looks like this could be coming back now with as Laundry is on the field.
Not his laundry, huh?
Well, it's somewhere. It's a handkerchief.
Handkerchief on the field. Potential illegal block, which would negate an exciting offensive explosion. And Phillips, an outstanding recruit all season long. But believe it or not, he's only got one interception. That was only his second for 1995 season.
On the run back, personal personal foul, flipping against White. First down.
That's Buddy Gingras, our referee tonight. David Bidjo, our umpire. Paul Parsons, our linesman. Frank White, the line judge. Reginald Dubrock, the field judge. Gerald Lemoyne, the back judge. Thomas Wilson, the clock operator. The crew hails out of the Alexandria area. So, Carl will put it in play, first and 10 at the Cecilia 44-yard line. Their second possession here with 6:59 left in the first quarter. No score in this AAA state championship game. Counter play, left-hand side. Corey Gibbons, John Baptiste making the stop.
Gibbons is quite a weapon. We got the call defense, Ruff and Johnson. Casby and Watkins, he's a good outside end. We've got the offense on the field right now, but what a defense Carr has. Really wreaked havoc on opposing offenses. Hey, good enough to take a second look at.
Hand off on a play that just does not develop.
Part of the reason is that there's a flag out on the play.
Con Watney wants an explanation. Illegal procedure against Carr. That'll push him back on second down.
Ball start, White, still second down.
Carr's had some penalty problems early going here against Cecilia. Cecilia's a team with a very potent offense, can take advantage, so Carr needs to cut back on their miscues, and Cecilia, they're done a good job on defense thus far.
Second and long, Sims pitches the ball out. Gibbons met. Drop back up to the original line of scrimmage. We'll call a trade down on 11. Corey Green, the all-district linebacker, playing that strong side, flying through and making the stop.
Carr with five penalties thus far for 40 yards has really shot themselves in the foot with 5 minutes and 50 seconds remaining here in the first period. You see Sims pitching out outside here to Corey Gibbons as he tries to skirt along the outside. He's stopped by Corey Green, and that defense is just skating along the line of scrimmage and stopping everything from going wide.
Sims stumbles as he pulls the snap down, tosses the ball downfield. Excellent defensive play. Robert Royal was the intended receiver. Chris Broussard right there applying the excellent coverage downfield.
And Broussard with that 6-foot frame really stretches out. He's a junior, 4'6 speed, an all-district cornerback, playing that weak cornerback, and he was right on target here. Just an excellent defensive play by Chris Broussard, intended for the tight end.
Credit Ernest Broussard, Renee, the senior right defensive tackle, with an excellent pressure of Edward Sims. And it'll be fourth down and 11 into the ball game. We'll check Jason Helmstetter, an outstanding punter for the Carr Cougars. Last time he was hurried and affected by a poor snap. This time he'll have a better effort. A high kick that'll come down to the 9-yard line to Charles Hathaway. He'll make it up to the 18, and Cecilia will clear the play. First and 10. We've got two defensive giants matching you up here. A 36-yard kick and a 10-yard return.
You may see in the back of all the helmets of Cecilia, number 15, that is, the season is dedicated to Jedediah Jones, I should say, who's a player for Cecilia that was injured in an automobile accident. He is presently in a coma. The team and followers have been praying for Jed Jones and have dedicated this game of the season to him.
Hand off on first and 10. Not much running room at all. And stiffly met, Corey Jackson falls into the grasp of number 41, Dwayne Lewis. With 5 minutes left in the first quarter, and we're scoreless here. Each team has had two possessions.
And watch Noel Ellis unload right here. Number 44 as he's dancing. Bang, right here, and he's going in a different direction. Noel Ellis is probably one of the best athletes on this team. Basketball player, you talked about him before the game. He will be some fine defensive back in college.
Handoff, skirting his way through. The fullback, Davis, just picked up the first down. Takes it up to the 34-yard line. The change will move. Noel Ellis, once again, applying the brakes. Can you talk about Noel? Renee Noel, in his first season of playing football, an outstanding player in basketball, and really for Coach Don Watney, he had an unknown commodity when this boy came out this year.
You see Jermaine Davis right there. He's a battler. He's a grunt, right? He gets the tough yards between the tackle, and he compliments Corey Jackson.
Bayraws tossing the ball in the flat, well overshoot of his intended receiver, Chad D'Artes, the all-district split end. In case you're wondering, no, there is no relation between Chad D'Artes and Jamaican D'Artes, the outstanding tailback for Cecilia.
Well, he's a cousin of Jamaican D'Artes. And you may remember Craig D'Artes. Craig D'Artes played for LSU as his brother.
Second and 10, Bayard looking deep down the field for D'Artes, overthrown, well covered on the play by Dwayne Lewis, who is in for Rasheed Johnson, the normal starting quarterback. He was injured on the last play. He came in tonight with a knee injury and was questionable for tonight's contest. Obviously out there early in the ball game, he had to take a spell and a blow on the sidelines as Lewis comes in for him, and Lewis covering on that play, D'Artes very well as he went down the field. It'll be third down and 10. You see, Barrage got it on. He airs it out. He's got over 1,100 yards on the season passing, 15 touchdowns. He's a baseball pitcher. We'll talk more about number two in just a moment. Slot right. Motion from the wide receiver. This play may come back for Cecilia. Bayard will keep it, rolling around the right-hand side. And he gets hit as he goes out of bounds. I mean, he was hit. He was absolutely crushed by Lance Groynes, the outside linebacker.
He hears bells, believe me, right now. He's not sure where he is. That was quite a hit. Not only did he take a tremendous hit from Lance Groynes, but that ground doesn't give very much. You can see coming up right here, number 95 is focusing on him. He knows he's going to unload on him just momentarily. Right near the sidelines, right there. Now, he was still in. He was still in, but evidently, in the official's opinion, he was heading for the sideline.
Well, Corey Jackson was looking downfield for the ball. He was able to turn around. He might have been able to throw a block and deflect that throw, but he was looking for the ball to be thrown. Bayard deciding to hold on to it. And probably the worst thing about this is that one of the receivers on the near sideline looked to be offsides, and he was. And Carl will be called for a personal foul on that play. So we've got offsides against Cecilia, which seemed to make the play for naught. And Carl will be called for a personal foul, which I'm guess would be leading with the headgear, using the crown of the helmet. Let's take another look at it. That's what he hit him for, using the crown right there to the neck.
Now that's what he hit him the penalty for, not hitting him out of bounds. He used the crown of the helmet, as you just mentioned.
That's what they're finding folks for in the NFL these days.
Well, that was quite a hit. And Lance Goings.
Illegal procedure on green, five, third down.
Buddy Jean Gros. And the winding, the confusion on the field for us. Now they'll mark off the personal foul.
Here's a series that has some athletes come through here. You talk about Jamaican D'Artes. Here's a fellow named Anthony Clement, who's a starting tackle for USF, 6'7", 335 pounds. There's a Nathan Perry, plays for LSU as a guard. And Brian Sonia is a play for Cecilia. He's a backup quarterback for USF. He'll probably be filling in when they need an extra quarterback, but he's being groomed as the next quarterback of USF.
Brian, the quarterback that took Cecilia here the last time they were in the game.
Exactly right.
Against the Carthagers. Okay, first and 10 for Cecilia. counter, Jackson, open field. He slips as he tries to make his cut, but he will pick up the first down and make it down to the 45-yard line. And Jackson's very slow to get up as he slipped on the artificial turf trying to make the cut.
Looks like a stomach or injury to his chest or stomach or ribs, perhaps. He may have pulled a stomach muscle, perhaps, but I tell you that turf will grab you at times if you're not used to running on it. He twisted his ankle, it looks like. Well, I tell you what a painful injury that might be. Because Corey Jackson is one of the primary foot soldiers for Cecilia. They appear to be administering to his upper body as he lays right around the 45-yard line. It's nothing here at the Superdome. Triple-A state final, 3:50 left in the first quarter. We'll take this time out.
National studies show that students who participate in high school activities, like music, sports, and drama, not only have better grades and attendance, they develop the character to handle adversity. The grace to accept defeat. And the self-confidence to start over.
Corey Jackson comes off the field under his own power, holding what appears to be his right arm in the break. The crowd chanting, Corey, Corey, Corey. He's been the main cog in this Bulldog offense, this successful 1995 campaign.
He shared the spotlight with Jamaican D'Artes in 1994, and in some ways he's a little different. He's a speed guy, straight up guy, but he's got 4.4 speed, very similar to Jamaican D'Artes. He's an all-district player this year, but he compares very favorably to Jamaican D'Artes. Wow, at the two-lane relay.
First and 10 after the Jackson run, onto the 46-yard line of Carr. And off first back through, banging his fullback Jermaine Davis, the senior battering ram mate of Corey Jackson. He'll gain 3, second and 7.
A little defensive front for Cecilia. That's Vitt, Dupree, Landry, Green, and Alamon. Alamon, a 6'1", 295-pounder. He's your left tackle, number 78 bench press. He's 240 pounds. He's a third-year starter, so they run his way when they need the tough yards.
Counter going the other way is Jonah Williams. No, check that. Play action pass down the middle. Incomplete to Jermaine Davis, the fullback. What an outstanding play action pass to fullback Rusty Gaylord. Full gate. Lance Goins finally makes the stop, a gain of 18 as Davis motors down the field and pulls in that pass from Bayard.
Well, Bayard's got good touch on the ball. He reminds me a little bit in the style to a Jamie Howard. And Bayard, we said, has a baseball background as a pitcher. He hit over 300 as a baseball player, so he may have a future in baseball or football.
2:51 left in the first quarter. Let's take this time out.
Team is on the field, our medics will be there just in case. Every weekend we'll be standing by at 100 high school and college football games. Acadian Ambulance and AirMed Services, looking after the ones you love.
As an employee-owned company, every day we are acquiring ownership in Acadian Ambulance, and every day we work harder to make the service even better.
We all try to do more than the job requires.
Because it's our company and our community.
And we want to give our best to both.
We're grateful for the opportunities to serve.
And for the acceptance the people we serve have given us.
Teaching community services is a big part of our business. We appreciate you entrusting your family to ours.
Cecilia trying to puncture the end zone on first and 10. Jerome Wiltz with the call. Corey Jackson is still on the sidelines for Cecilia, nursing what appears to be a right elbow injury. applying some ice to the area. He's now standing a little bit closer on the sidelines. The coach Waggis back. He'll be coming in the ballgame momentarily.
Happy fans here watching this game. Coach Wayne Hardy, you got a shot of him a second ago. He's done a great job with his hard defense, allowing just 5 points per game defensively. What an outstanding season they've had.
Arod, deep drop, will roll out of the pocket. He tossed the ball downfield and incomplete. Barkley is shaken up. Lying down on the turf.
Not sure who it is, but Arod rolling left, making a difficult throw.
Let's take this injury timeout here at the Dome. We're scoreless in the AAA state championship.
You ever hear anyone talk about life like you gotta chew it up and spit it out? You gotta want it so bad you can taste it. You gotta be hungry. If so, Gatorade has one question for you. You want something to drink with that? Because you're going to be thirsty. Life is a sport. Drink it up.
So what's it going to be, Dion? Football or baseball?
Both, boss.
Both?
Both.
Offense or defense?
Both.
Both?
Both.
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 Pizza Hut?
Meat lovers or stuffed crust pizza?
Both.
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 Want it all? Now Pizza Hut offers our Lovers Line toppings. Meat lovers, pepperoni lovers, or supreme. Piled high in a stuffed crust pizza.
So what'll it be, Dion? 15, 20 million?
Both.
Both. You'll love the stuff we're made of.
David Watkins coming out of the game very gingerly for Carter right in. He's their leading tackler. It'd be a big loss if he's not able to come back. On third and 10, Baylor drops the back and tosses the ball incomplete for Dartez, his intended receiver. Wayne Lewis down there on the coverage. And Chad Dartez, we talked about him. He's the cousin of Jamaican Dartez. His brother, Craig Dartez, played for LSU in the early 80s. He played for Cecilia in the early 80s, played with LSU in the mid-80s. But good football fan of Chad, a 4'7 guy. There's Berard, a good look at Berard. And he makes some good decisions, dropping back. Good form right here. Holds the ball up, fires, and loads right here. Good spiral, good delivery on his passes. Andy Chance will attempt a 43-yard field goal. Good snap and kick is off and to the side. No good, in and out of the end zone. Of course, in high school, a field goal attempt is just like a punt. It'll be first and 10 for the Carr Cougars from their own 20. With 1:55 left in the first quarter, we're fought to a scoreless tie here in the Superdome. 1:55 left here, and this has been everything it's built to be. Cecilia and Carr, two teams with stout defenses, don't give up many points. In fact, Cecilia's given up 12 points a game to their opponent, Carr, with a minor 5 points per outing to their opponents to the 1995 season, including the playoffs. And they led every team in the playoffs with 6 shutouts throughout the entire season. And one team they shut out in the playoffs, so they've got a pretty potent defense. Sims has a full house backfield behind him. Hand off. Givens, near side. They get across the 25, up to the 26. It'll be second down and 4.
You know, Givens is quite a story here. He's only 5'6", 155 pounds. You can see he's tough to bring down in his cross handoff here. Breaks one tackle right here and keeps on going. Broke the tackle by Wilkes. He's not an easy guy to bring down. He scored 5 touchdowns against Faraday in the semifinal, so he plays good in the big games.
Second and short. Back split. Pitch out. Givens, right side. They'll elude one tackle, make it out of the backfield, and pick up some positive yards. Great second effort by Corey Givens. Andy Chance finally hauls him down, but he was caught in the backfield before he finally got outside, and another Carr player is slow to get up.
And that looks like, in fact, you can see Chris Broussard turned it inside. He played contain, and he did not allow Corey Givens to get outside wide. But another injury for the Carr Cougars.
Halfback Troy Harrison, slow to get up. They'll take the injury timeout and come back. Scoreless contest here at the Superdome.
Place, a wide open range where the spirit's free to roam.
Harrison getting up slowly and coming out of the ballgame. Of course, Leonard Welsh has been hobbled by an ankle injury. Now Harrison going out very slowly on the far sidelines. Limping, we may see John Brown into the ballgame, one of the third halfbacks. It's a good shot of Harrison coming off to the far side. And Carr will employ a full house backfield on third and short from their own 29. Givens is your deep back. Double tight end. Givens gets the call. Surges forward. I do not think he made it.
And you credit Theo Singleton for making that outstanding defensive play. He was shooting as the ball was snapped. The sophomore really disrupted the momentum of that play and perhaps prevented a first down.
And it will be fourth down. No gain on that last play, so fourth and 10, and out once again will trot Jason Helmstetter for his third punt of the state championship game. Helmstetter will set up camp at his own 16-yard line. Hackworth back at his 35. Clean snap. Nice punt by Helmstetter. High, soft, spiraling kick that Hackworth will call for and execute a fair catch at his own 41. A 30-yard kick. First and 10 for the Bulldogs with 10 seconds left in the first quarter. We're scoreless.
They are getting instructions from the coaching staff in Cecilia. Coach Waggis back and coming in to prepare for an opportunity as the first quarter winds down. Here's some of the faithful here for the Carr Cougars. Of course, there's three more games in action on tap for tomorrow. Carr Cougars with two injuries to Watkins and Corey Harrison thus far early in the game.
First and 10 for Cecilia. Handoff pounding on the left-hand side is Jermaine Davis. Pickup of one, maybe two. It'll be second down and 8. The thing that Cecilia was most concerned about was getting off to a good start. And, it's been a 0-0 game thus far. That's the end of the first quarter, and we are scoreless here at the Superdome. We'll play 12 minutes with 36 yet to come for this AAA state championship game. Back right after this.
Abita Springs Water, your local bottled water company, is proud to offer the Home Team Special. Become a new Abita Springs customer and get your first 10 5-gallon bottles at half price. More quality, more service, more for less. More reasons to switch to the Home Team. Abita Springs Water, more water per gallon.
David Watkins, the leading tackler for the Carr Cougars, the right end, still seated on the bench on the far sidelines. Removing his sock and checking out his right ankle.
That's going to the first quarter. Cecilia with 32 yards rushing. Carr with 21 passing. 39 yards for Cecilia, 32 for Carr.
Pitch out, Jackson near side. Kicking his holes, waiting for his blocks. And he pushed out short of the 50 around the 48-yard line. It'll be third down. And, you know, we made a difference right now in this ballgame is Jerry Phillips' interception return called back. He scored it, but Carr called for an illegal block.
Yeah, this is a game of opportunity, and you have to make the most of the opportunities, and that was one of those chances that Carl let slip away with an illegal block that was called back, but there'll be more opportunities for both of these schools if Woods are not here this evening.
Third and four for Cecilia. Jackson and I, three-step drop, toss the ball for Darkness, he receives it, picks up the first down. Jukes one player, gets wrestled down about the 41-yard line, but first down yardage for Chad Dartez, down in the Carl Cooper territory, the chains will move.
There's Jerry Phillips once again. What an athlete he is. He's got four or five, he plays that free safety position. He also plays on the basketball team with Noel Ellis, but Bayrod, you see, sets up and fires straight to the sideline. Still hit the ball blocked, but a good catch by Dartez. Those were to do with it with that 4-7 speed. Cuts back right there, and a good move on Lewis, who he's brought to the surface by Jerry Phillips.
First and 10, toss sweep near side. Jackson kicking a hole. Look at him motor inside the 30. Ball comes loose. Bounding free at the 20. It's picked up by Dartez, and he's going to go into the end zone for a touchdown. What a peculiar play. One as that ball popped right up to Chad Dartez. Right place, right time, right touchdown.
And Dartez knows what to do with it. Well, I'll tell you what, that had some crazy bounces to that game, that ball right there. As you see, the Corey Jackson starts to turn up field right here. The ball is going to be popped from his possession right about here as Jerry Phillips walks out. He's hit from the blind side and pops through. Well, Ellis could get to it, fighting over it, and Greg Dartez. Chad Dartez is jumping on the spot, dances it to the last 20 yards into the end zone, puts Cecilia ahead, 6-0.
Andy Chance in to attempt the extra point. And the ball is up. And no good. Pulled off to the left side. So the score remains 6-0. Cecilia over the Carl Cougars. 11:21 left until halftime. Carl's offense will take a shot at even it up right after this.
Just a reminder that kids who participate in high school sports tend to go a little farther than those who don't.
Welcome back to the Superdome. Gerald Duhon along with Renee Nato. Ball gathered in by a car as they move from our left to our right. Joe Walker. Get wrestled down, score the 25, and out will trot Edward Sims to try to ignite the Carl offense.
What a crazy series of events happened right here as Jackson advanced the ball forward before being hit by Phillips in the front and another Carl Cougar from the back. Noel Ellis could not get to it, neither could a Cecilia player. And it advances forward to Dartez, scoops it up, and prances into the end zone the last 17 yards. And the extra point was not successful. So with 11:08 remain before the halftime break, it's Cecilia 6 and Carl nothing.
First and 10 for the Cougars at their own 26-yard line. Back split. Sims rolls out, wants the pass, will deep down the field, intercepted, Chance coming back the other way, cuts it at the 45, picking his block, down to the 40, flag on the play, and Chance will finally be stood up at the Carl Cougar 36-yard line.
And Chance with an outstanding interception. He's only a sophomore. Not only is he a kicker, he's the free safety, or he's a quarterback, and he's the backup quarterback. He's tall, got a good coverage ability, and he brings it back, but it's going to be a penalty. Cecilia will retain possession of the ball, but you can see as Sims drops back, airs it out, perhaps a little too much air into the ball, looking for his receiver deep, dialing deep, and that pass was intended for Don Brewer. Yeah, Don Brewer, and Chance just steps in between and knows what to do with the ball tucked under his own, being a back and quarterback, but he was really hit right here at the end, but I think a block below the waist will bring it back.
Against the green, first down.
That's it.
So that'll back Cecilia up significantly because it's from the point of the foul, so they'll put it in play first and 10 from their own 32. Instead of having it into Carr Cooper territory, they'll start with decent position in their own territory.
Well, that was from the point of the foul, so that's why so much yardage was amassed against Cecilia. But Cecilia does hold the advantage on the scoreboard, 6-0 with 10:33 remaining here in the AAA state finals here at the Superdome.
Back split behind quarterback Bayward. They drop back, look downfield on the play action, and toss the ball right over the middle, incomplete. His receiver Jonah Williams fell down, so the ball harmlessly fell to the turf. It is second down and 10.
And Watkins is back in the lineup for the Carr Cougars with his left ankle heavily taped. He's that guy that they need in there. He's the pass rusher. He's got some business. We're going to talk about some of these prospects that Carr has. David Watkins is being looked at by Tennessee, Nicholls State, McNeese, Tulane, and USL. He will visit Arkansas in the next few weeks.
Good shot of James Waggis back, the head coach of Cecilia, taking St. James to the state title back in 1979, taking these Cecilia Bulldogs to the state finals three times, tonight being the third. On first down, Jackson, out of his tailback slot, will surge forward. They pick up one, so it'll be third down and 9.
He talked about Noel Ellis. He's number 44 for the Carr Cougars. He was questionable with a knee injury, but I'll tell you, when the lights go on, you can tell who the real players are. And he just has to shrug off that pain and inconvenience of a knee injury. He's going to be wearing a knee brace throughout this entire game, but there's no tomorrow. This is the last game of the season for both of these teams.
Third and long for Cecilia. Handoff, beat back through is Jackson, and he'll be well short of the first down. As Cecilia would appear to punt. With 9:24 left until halftime, protecting a 6-0 lead, the ball at their own 36.
You know, the thing about this Carr defense, Gerald, is they play that split 40, four down linemen, four linebackers, and they play a gap control. They have good athletes. They can, I guess not gamble, but they can beat their blockers one-on-one, and they're just a tough defense to block against.
Andy Chance stands back at his own 24-yard line. Back deep for the Cougars is Lewis and Phillips. High snap. Chance has to hurry. Gets off a nice effort. That'll come down to Phillips. He'll reverse his field, try to get outside. And will not as he snowed under back at the 26-yard line. Excellent play by the Cecilia special teams as they cover downfield. Corey Green, one of your big guys, 6'2", 210, hustling down the field. A 34-yard kick, a negative 2-yard return.
We look at Jerry Phillips right there, and he's another one of those prospects. He's being recruited pretty heavily himself. Tulane, Florida State, Texas A&M, Notre Dame are looking very closely at number 30. And an athlete, he will visit LSU as well in the next few weeks, Jerry Phillips.
First and 10 for the Cougars at their own 27-yard line. Double wide receivers on the right-hand side. Tight end on the left. Baxter split. Six-man Cecilia front. Sims options the ball out to Gibbons. He's hit, rolls forward, and picks up some nice positive yardage to Corey Gibbons, who kept his balance and kept those feet moving. And that translates into a quick gain on the play of 6 yards, second and 4.
And he was hit by Israel Singleton, the strong safety, who came up to meet him, but showed what kind of balance he had. He advanced forward for a nice gain, and it's now second and 4 yards with a 6-yard pickup. Good look at number 74, Bernard Robinson, All-Metro player.
Was an offensive tackle, moved to the inside because he could run. On second and 4, Jerome Wilkes breaks up the Sims pass. down marker will click over to three. And Carr will try to avoid going three and out with a first down conversion here. And Wilt's really a good athlete. He's got a 4.6 speed, an all-district performer for the Cecilia team. And, you know, he's a leading tackler, but he always comes up with a big play, number six. He's all over the field, played a little offense in the first quarter, but his best position is Mike linebacker, where he's installed at 5'11", 210-pound senior. Carr, 0-for-3 on third down conversions. Counter, Gibbons. It cracked the 35 and will be well short of the first down. Stopped at the 36-yard line, DeWinus Richard. The Will, weak inside linebacker coming through to make the stop and into the ball game will trot Helmstetter for yet another Carr Cougar punt.
You see a misdirection right here, and Gibbons really can't go anywhere. Nowhere to run. He's got 269 yards on the season, but he's been kept up pretty quiet by Cecilia defense thus far. He's got 23 yards for the seven carries for the Carr Cougars.
Fourth and a long one. Ball with the ball at their own 36. Helmstetter into the ball game. The punt, Hackworth, stands at his own 31. Clean snap, low line drive kick. Hackworth will field it on the run. Make a move and he drills down right at the 40. And Cecilia will put it in play. First and 10. A 29-yard kick and a 5-yard return. It's added by Freddie Baldwin, special teams demon of the Carr Cougars.
And as you mentioned, Gerald, Cecilia sets up shop at their own 42-yard line with 6:52 remaining here. And Cecilia with a 6-point advantage. 6-0 over the Carr Cougars.
It's been all defense here at the Superdome. Double wide out to right hand side. Strength of the formation is to the left with the tight end. Handoff, first back through, gets the call. That's Jermaine Davis. Davis has actually carried the ball more times this season than Corey Jackson has. Davis 173 times coming into tonight's game. Jackson 161, but Jackson in the tailback spot, averaging 8.5 yards a carry, comes into tonight's game with almost 1,400 yards. Davis averaging 4.8 yards a carry, has a little bit over 800 yards. So although Davis has moved more, used more from the fullback spot, Jackson has higher numbers.
Also, Jackson has 16 touchdowns to his credit, where Davis has 10.
And 8 receiving touchdowns for Jackson, too. He's dangerous catching and running. D'Artes takes the flare-out pass from Bayard and turns it into a gain of 3. It'll be third down and short for Cecilia. Delando Davis and Noel Ellis combining on the stop. And actually, they're spotting that ball even further down the field than I thought. It would be first and 10 for Cecilia. D'Artes knew just where those sticks were and laid out for him.
You know, this number 73 right there, Bart Vitt, he's a 5'11", 200-pound sophomore. He started for the Cecilia group as a freshman. This speaks in volumes of a player who can come in as a ninth grader and play for a successful program like Cecilia. Bart Vitt, keep an eye on him for the future.
Handoff once again to Davis, surging forward. Quick gain of 3. It'll be second down and 7. Cecilia, winners of 50 of their last 58 ball games. An outstanding stat. I've got one for the Carr Cougars, too. 36-5 the last 3 seasons. Of course, they did not play varsity ball before that. Carr turning from a junior high to a senior high and has really changed the landscape of the Metro New Orleans prep powerhouses. Carr is now one of them. Second down and 7. Bayard keeps it on the option and he'll pick up the first down and get it inside the 35, down to the 34. Joseph Lyons calls down senior quarterback Rusty Bayard, a 10-yard pickup.
You know, Bayard really is a good quarterback, makes good decisions. He can get you out of some errors, and you know, he's thrown for over 1,000 yards in 94, 1,000 yards in 95, very consistent. And we go back to it. Again, he makes good reads, good decisions, and it's his decision to pitch or keep, and he keeps it right here for a good gain, freezes that pitch man and the defensive player, and makes a good gain for Cecilia.
And off once again to fullback Davis, put power inside the 30. Down to the 28. And the Cecilia offensive line is doing the job.
Once again, Carr's secretary called upon to make a stop. Dwayne Lewis following down Davis, but not before he picks up a quick six. It'll be second down and four. And Alomar, Green, Landry, Dupree, and Vic doing their work up front for the Bulldog offense. Pitch out Jackson, trying to pick a hole. Well strong, he's going to cut it back against the green, and that's ill-advised. They'll lose yardage on that play. Back to the original line of scrimmage, and then some. Grant Johnson making the stop.
And Grant Johnson, only a junior, really plays as well. Good pursuit. He squares up. He doesn't go for any fakes. And number 66 is going to put the stop on Corey Jackson. And we mentioned Grant Johnson, only a junior, 6'1", 230. Right here, puts a big paw on him, and down he goes. You can hear Grant Johnson's name. He'll be a prospect in 1996, only a junior.
Third and nine. Bayrod down the field, completes the Dartez. He's got the first down all the way down to the 15. Ball pops out, but right back up to Dartez. Excellent counter play, excellent pass. Check that. That was Charles Hackworth on the reception. Nice read by quarterback Bayrod to pick up the open receiver, Hackworth.
And Hackworth with a good catch. He's consistent. He's very much of a possession receiver. Catches his catch number 10 of the 1995 season. He averages 21.7 yards every time he catches the ball, but Bayrod really took a shot to the chops, as does Hackworth on the tackle here.
Timeout on the field, 6-0. Cecilia Bulldogs want more as they're at the Carr 13-yard line with 3:14 left until halftime here. The AAA state championship game in the Superdome. Back with more in a moment.
On the field, our medics will be there just in case. Every weekend, we'll be standing by at 100 high school and college football games. Acadian Ambulance and AirMed Services, looking after the ones you love.
As an employee-owned company, every day we are acquiring ownership in Acadian Ambulance, and every day we work harder to make the service even better.
We all try to do more than the job requires.
Because it's our company and our community,
and we want to give our best to both.
We're grateful for the opportunities to serve.
And for the acceptance the people we serve have given us.
Teaching community services is a big part of our business. We appreciate you entrusting your family to ours.
On first down, Jermaine Davis churns his big body forward, lumbering all the way down to the Carr 6-yard line for a quick pickup of six. Jamal Casby finally makes the stop. It'll be second down and four for Cecilia, threatening here late in the second quarter.
And you see Berard here, that was a prior play as he took a shot as he delivered the ball to Charles Hackworth to get him in shape here. And then, of course, Davis gets him where they are right now at the 6-yard line.
Jackson and I. Toss Wilkes, left-hand side. Stopped at the five. He'll crack it, get inside the four, and it'll be third down and two. Corey Harrison, the inside linebacker, the senior, 5'10", 210, flying through to make the stop. They'll spot it right at the five-yard line, so it'll actually be a long two, third and two.
And Wilkes, they come in for a little extra punch here. He's a 210-pound prospect. He's a short yardage guy. He's an all-district performer on defense, but he comes in to give them some extra punch in the red zone.
Dartez and Hackworth split out wide on the right-hand side. Toss sweep, Jackson near side, strung out, stops, rattles in the background, and falling behind the line. Jimmy Ferguson read it perfectly, coming through, making the stop, a loss of one, and in will come the field goal unit for Cecilia.
And Jimmy Ferguson, with an outstanding effort from his outside linebacker position, you can see he skates right here, skates to the sidelines, squares his shoulders, and you're not going to get outside of Jimmy Ferguson. 4.7 speed. He's being recruited by Arkansas, Texas A&M, LSU, Nichols, and Tulane. He will visit Tulane, and Texas A&M is hot on the trail of the 6'1", 205-pound senior, Jimmy Ferguson.
Andy Chance to attempt a 24-yard field goal to try to give the Bulldogs a 9-point bulge over the Cougars.
Snap is back, ball is down, kick is up, and good. 1 minute left until halftime. It's a 9-0 Cecilia lead. The Carr defense holds, but Cecilia comes away with some points.
Watch Save Sideline, brought to you by Lennox, Louisiana Gas Service Company, and Pawpaw's Capper City.
Who that tells it straight about the Saints?
Oh, yeah!
Save Sideline!
For all the Saints action on and off the field, it's Saints Sideline, Monday night at 6:30 on WGNO 26.
Did you see the field goal attempt of 24 yards per chance, the second score of the game, and they've got a 9-0 ball game.
11 plays, 52 yards for Cecilia Bulldogs, 5:52 up the clock, 24-yard field goal by chance, 9-0 Cecilia over Carr.
Kickoff coming down to Joe Walker for Carr, and they get dropped just short of the 30-yard line, so with 53 seconds left, out will trot Carr quarterback Edward Sims, and we'll see what he can muster for the Cougar offense with, as we mentioned, 53 seconds left until halftime, 9-0 Cecilia.
And Carr is really not as concerned. I'd like to get on the board, but like to regroup a little bit at halftime. He come out, you see Edward Sims coming on the field. He's the quarterback for the Carr Cougars. And they have a lot of weapons, so they'll be back in this game. This game is far from over. I'm sure Cecilia has some weapons to put some points on the scoreboard before it's all over as well.
Sims hands off to Corey Harrison. Ball comes loose. It looks like it's recovered by Cecilia. They're going to let it stand, and it is. I thought I heard a whistle, but obviously not, as Cecilia recovered the ball. Israel Singleton, right place, right time, and yes, Bulldog football. They've got a chance to pick up some more down at the Carr 35. They're partying in at Indiana.
And you can see some happy fans that trek down from Cecilia to make this a momentous occasion. And it looked like it could have been a dead ball right there, but the official sees it otherwise, and Cecilia has an opportunity with 36 picks to go here before the halftime break. And Singleton, Johnny on the spot, he was really quick to the ball.
Timeout on the field, we'll take it to 9-0 Bulldogs over the Cougars.
When these guys meet the competition, teamwork and communications are the keys to a winning game plan. For reliable communications, these teams depend on Tomba Communications, the authorized Motorola dealer for the New Orleans area. Tomba features the latest Motorola two-way radio technology, like the new Visor that fits in the palm of your hand, yet is more powerful than two-way radios twice its size. When your winning game plan requires reliable communications, call Tomba, the communications team you can depend on.
Continental Airlines, now among the best in the business of getting you to your destination on time.
Welcome back. You get another look at the play, Renee, and it seemed like Harrison was down when this ball squirted out.
Well, the ground cannot cause a fumble, Joe, and it looked to me, from my vantage point, that Corey Harrison hit the ground and the ball squirted out, but the official was right there, and there's no questioning the stripes. They don't have an eye. They don't have the option of a replay. But you can see right here, Corey Harrison dancing around, and you see he's upended. And before, when he does go down, when he hits the surface, the ball squirts loose. But they see otherwise, and you see his hand is still in possession of Corey Harrison until he hits the ground.
Carr charged with a timeout here, so a chess match going on with 36 seconds left until halftime. 9-0. Cecilia on top. You'll get another look at it. As Harrison falls down, his body does shield, so you can't see if he's juggling the ball as he goes to the ground, but it clearly squirts out as he hits the ground.
Well, it looks like it's in his possession right here. Now, this is an official right in front of the camera right here. From his vantage point, it would have been tough to see if the ball was coming out prior to that. You see, the shoulder pad blocks the view of the pigskin, but in his vantage point, he says the ball came out.
Let's take the timeout as they unravel it down on the field. We'll be ready to go in just a moment. 36 seconds left until halftime, 9-0 Cecilia. It'll be 1st and 10 for Cecilia from the car, 35 is... They try to take advantage of the car miscue. Bayrod pitch out to Chink. She's in the backfield. He wants the pass. Looking downfield. Passing the ball in the end zone for Darjeel. Intercepted by Noel Ellis in the end zone. Ellis' second pickoff of this ball game. And Jerry Phillips munching in excitement in the back of the end zone.
And that is Noel Ellis's 50th interception of the season. He has been a demon back there, and Noel Ellis shows why some of the schools are looking for him. He just played the ball, played center field from his defensive back position, and Bayrod just airs it out. Oh, I'm sorry, Chance, who is, keep in mind, he is a backup quarterback. As he circles the ball, he sells the defense on him running a sweep and then just airs it out deep. But that a great ability by Noel Ellis pulls it down in the end zone away from D'Artez, and now with just 26 ticks, the Car Cougars get it back and just have lost 6 seconds off the clock from their last possession.
I said Ellis' second interception. That's his first. Early in the game, Jerry Phillips had the other Cougar interception. That was just pure athlete against pure athlete right there. And Sims wants no part of that. He'll just kneel down at the 19 and put the clock in motion. Car out of timeouts here in this second half. They'll be content to go to the locker room, trailing by 9 to regroup. We've played 24 minutes of football here from the Louisiana Superdome. It's a 9-0 Cecilia Bulldog advantage of the Car Cougars at halftime. We'll be back with the halftime show. Enjoy the bands before more football action.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We now present our halftime entertainment. First, the Edna Carr Marching Band takes the field under the direction of drum majors Tony Licata and Quincy Williams. Tonight marks the 19th football team at which the Cougar Band has performed this season. Entering with the band are the Carr majorettes under the direction of Ms. Pat Charles, the Carr Dwelling Sensation under the direction of Ms. Joan Fish, the Fantastic Flags under the direction of Ms. Lynn Ravazzo, and the Cougarettes under the direction of Ms. Constance Surrett. Edna Carr Magnet School, academics, athletics, and the arts all work together as part of the Carr family. As a band performs Randall Smith, best friend, we would like to celebrate our football team's perfect season. First, we sell out our team's record of 14-0. The band now begins the future as we sell out our team's record after this game, 15-0. Anyone still wondering who is the best AAA football team in Louisiana, we'll even give you their initials. Okay. as a Kruger family, wherever they may go, they are never alone. To reinforce this fact, we now feature Kruger Band 8th grader, Ryan Rice, as the band performs Michael Jackson, "You Are Not Alone." Dancers under the direction of Ms. Bonnie LaGasse and the assistance of Mrs. Cheryl Twicker. We now feature the Car Pride, the Kruger Band, and all of the sport groups as the band celebrates the fact that our team completely wiped out all of its competition this season. What better song to celebrate this competition? What better song to celebrate this than the Beach Boys' classic Wipeout? As we talk about the Anthem Cars Championship season, the Kruger Marching Band congratulates our team and wishes everyone a fond farewell. We'll be seeing you back in the dome in 1996. The car band is, car band director is Mr. Guy Wood. The car principal is Mr. John Heiser. The Kruger mascot is Devonica Deal. And the fantastic flags are under the direction of Mrs. Glenn Villavezo.
do that dance hop, do that dance, do that dance freak, do the upside hop, do, do the upside hop, do the upside hop, hop. Just work it, work it, just work it, work it, just work it, man, just work it, man, just work it, work it, just get it, get it, just work it, man, just work it, man, just work it, work it, just get it, get it, just work it, man, just work it, man, just work it, work it, just get it, get it, just up, down, up, just up, down.
Made a routine to it. Want to see it? Here it go.
Check this out.
Pump up the volume, pump up the volume, pump up the volume. Dance, dance.
Shake it like a dog, 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 shake it, shake it, shake it, kick it.
After every game, talk to me, Buddy D.
Want an honest opinion about the boys in black and gold?
Hey, man, were you watching the same game I was watching?
Hey, buddy, when you said that last week, I thought you were crazy, man, but you called it right again.
Talk to Buddy D. Nobody else tells it like it is.
Talk Saints football with me, Buddy D, on WWL 870 AM.
That's WWL 870 AM, News Talk Sports Radio.
Gang, what do you think about this motor home?
That's a great motor home, Papa.
Okay, good job. Christy, what do you think about this camper?
That's a great camper, Papa.
Okay.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. John, what do you think about this motor home?
Good motor home, Papa.
Okay, thank you, John. That's a good motor home, Papa.
We like to play some of Mike's greatest hits.
Yeah.
Sunday nights on WWL TV.
You ever hear anyone talk about life like you gotta chew it up and spit it out? You gotta want it so bad you can taste it. You gotta be hungry. If so, Gatorade has one question for you. You want something to drink with that? Because you're gonna be thirsty. Life is a sport. Drink it up.
Oh!
nothing right now. There's a series of Bulldogs on top of the Carr Cougars in this Triple-A state final matchup here at the Louisiana Superdome. I'm Gerald Duhon along with Renee Nato, and it's been Cecilia opportunism so far this game that has helped them out to that 9-0 lead, Renee.
And Cecilia with over 130 yards in total offense. Carr can only muster 54 in time of possession. Cecilia with over 14 minutes with the ball, and of course Carr can only hold the ball for 9 minutes, but it'll be a different game. And keep in mind, both of these teams are very defensive minded, so it's going to be tough to score.
Cecilia scoring first on a 17-yard Chad D'Artes fumble return for a touchdown. Also a chance 24-yard field goal, and it's 9-0 right now. Cecilia on top of the Carr. Let's take a look at the halftime stats, Renee. Rushing yardage in favor of the Bulldogs.
Yes, in fact, as we mentioned, 90 yards for Cecilia, 33, and then the total offense, 135 for Cecilia, 54 for Carr. And the first downs, Cecilia with 9 first downs, and Carr can only muster 1 turnovers, 2 for each team, and a big fumble by Carr really was, towards the end of the half, was a big momentum factor for Cecilia.
Let's highlight as well Jerry Phillips returning an interception on Cecilia's first drive for an apparent touchdown. That play called back because of blocking infraction against the Carr Cougars. That negated Carr's only penetration into the end zone, so it's 9-0. Not too dissimilar, Renee, from the first time these two teams met, which was in the state championship 2 years ago. Cecilia taking a 10-0 lead into the final 3 minutes of the ball game before Carr came roaring back. Patrick Surtan to Ivory Phillips. Ivory Phillips, 29-yard pass, made it 10-7 in that ball game with 3:30 left in the game. And then Mike Brown hitting a 28-yard field goal with 8 seconds left, tied it up at 10. Carr would win it in halftime, in overtime. Underway in the second half as the ball is bobbled by Jackson around the 11-yard line. And they'll be snowed under and stopped by a host of Carr Cougar tacklers. So Cecilia, with their first possession of the second half, will have it cut out for it.
And Corey Jackson is holding his wrist. He suffered a stomach problem in the first half. As you can see, the Carr Cougars going to the sidelines, including many of the special teams players. But they can ill afford to lose Corey Jackson as he drops off the field, and it'll be tough. You see right here, he's engulfed by a sea of white jerseys, and he's pulled back. He sprained his right wrist. We don't know how, perhaps trying to stiff arm a player, but they can ill afford to lose him. Wilt steps in place.
He's been in and out with that wrist all night long. He's a tough player. We'll see a lot of him. Jermaine Davis on first down, surging forward over the 10, up to the 11 and the 12. Jamal Cosby, the outstanding Cougar players, making the stop on that throw.
And Jamal Cosby, in case that name rings a bell, his dad, Tyrone, is the coach at Landry. And Cosby really is one of those players that disrupts everything, gets good penetration. He's being recruited as well by Nichols, McNeese, USL, Northwest Louisiana, and Alabama State, number 69, Jamal Cosby, a fine defensive lineman.
It'll be second down and 8. For the Cecilia Bulldogs.
Let's take a shot at David Watkins. He's another fine player. He'll visit Arkansas. We'll talk about the prospects he has. A 6'4", 215-pound defensive end, David Watkins.
Handoff on the counter. Surging forward is Jonah Williams. Get up to the 15, a 3-yard gain. Getting third down and 5, and once again, Cosby on the stop. Cosby, 6'0", 230, he's a senior. One fumble recovery, 2 fumbles, and 6 sacks coming into tonight's game. Williams with a little spry step. He's only a sophomore, 155-pound tailback, but he knows what to do with the ball under his arm. Not much running room there for Williams, but he's replaced by Corey Green, the Corey Jackson, as he comes back into the game. Replaces Williams, and Cecilia's looking to maintain some ball control as they have in the first half.
Hayward keeps it on the option, the quarterback option, and well defensed by Carr and Shannon Smith, the junior inside linebacker. And Cecilia will be forced to punt for opening possession of the third quarter. It's the first time that Cecilia has been halted in their offensive
game plan. And you see Watkins turns it in right here and allows Shannon Smith to make the stop as Carr has really turned it up a notch and made some defensive adjustments. Remember, they use that gap control defense and played outstanding throughout the season, only allowing 5 points per game to their opponents.
Chance stands back at his own one. Phillips and Lewis, and his cap goes over the head of Chance and out of the end zone for a safety. Carr picks up a safety. 9-2. And Cecilia will have to punt it back to Carr. Chance throwing his arms up. He never had a shot at the ball. The ball clearly snapped over his head, sailing out of the end zone. Let's take a look at the replay.
And it does sail over his head. He just, there's not much he can do for that. In fact, he's lucky the ball was not recovered because it would have been a touchdown. But it sails Hunsley out of bounds, out of the end line, and there will be a safety. Carr won't get possession, so Cecilia will not only suffer 2 points, but they'll have to relinquish the ball to Carr Cougars.
Touchdown in an extra point as Carr's got an extra point kicker, and Matt Dick will tie the ball game at 9 apiece. Of course, now Cecilia's missed extra point on their first touchdown, and the field goal they worked so hard to get in the first half is now negated by that safety, which is 7 point game we have right now.
It makes you wonder if Carr does happen to be fortunate enough to score a touchdown, would you go for 2 points depending on the game situation, how much time is left, and so on? But it calls for a decision if that opportunity presents itself. But Cecilia has not allowed much offense in the Carr Cougar offense, and Cecilia has done pretty good. This is the first time they've had trouble offensively throughout this game.
As we mentioned at the head of this half, and very similar to the last time these two teams played in the state finals, which was the last time they met, Cecilia held that 10-0 advantage until late in the game before the Carr offense finally came alive. You know, the Carr offense much maligned this year, blasted early on as being not quite up to speed with the defense, but believe it or not, last year Carr's offense averaged 27 points. This year Carr's offense averaged 27 points. The free kick will come down to Joe Walker for Carr. Trigger across the 40. The ball squirts free. Cecilia thinks they've come up with it. And the Carr players pointing the other way. And it will remain Cougar ball. First and 10 for Carr.
That's been a tough spot on the field for the Carr Cougars. They fumbled a ball almost into the identical spot in the second quarter near the halftime break. And the ball went over to Cecilia, and once again the ball is fumbled, but in this particular case Carr retains possession. As you see, Ed Sims got onto the field. He's that quarterback, really done a good job in the playoffs taking control. He's got good reads, second year starter. He's good at running, and I tell you, don't be surprised, he can air it out 45 yards with some accuracy.
Handoff is given to the lead back. The medical line of scrimmage is given back there to lose a yard. Excellent pursuit by Jerome Wilkes, the leading tackler, all district middle linebacker, and Theo Singleton as well on that play. Call it first and 11 for Carr with 9:05 left in the third quarter, and Cecilia holding on to a 9-2 advantage.
Theo Singleton, what a prospect he's going to be. He's only a sophomore, wears number 34. He can rush a quarterback, Joe, and be quick enough to go downfield and make a tackle on a screen play to the running back. So he's got tremendous pursuit ability.
Flags coming out as this play is unable to get off. We'll listen to referee Buddy John Graw. Football foul for CJ. The call against Carr. That'll back him up another 5, so we'll have a second and short 15. Very long 16. A short 16 or a long 15.
You know, the things that Cecilia needs to do to win this game is stop the big play, stop the option, and stop the long pass. And they've done all three thus far as we approach 8 minutes and 44 seconds remaining in the third stanza.
Sims beneath center. They turn the ball upfield on the quarterback keeper, get across the 40, look it up to the 41. He'll get back to the original line of scrimmage. Corey Green laying the lumber. Corey Green's got one of the most outstanding stats I think I've seen this prep season, Renee, and that is he's blocked 6 punts. That's unreal.
Yeah, he's also got 9 passes broken up and caused 8 fumbles, and he's got 103 tackles on the season. You can see this is another tackle that he's going to perform right here, but Sims is bent in half right here, and you can credit Chris Broussard for a low tackle right in the ribs, and he'll feel that for quite a while.
Third and 10. Sims, he'll roll right, set up with time. Now he'll tuck it under and run. Back it up to the 43, well shy of the first down. Flag on the play. Sims saying his face mask was grabbed.
Well, it may be, if it is a face mask, it may be 5 yards, and I'm just surmising that.
Grabbing the face mask on Cecilia. Bulldogs,
that'll be 15 yards. All face mask contractions in high school are 15 yards. That'll bring it down to the 42-yard line. You're right. This is not a Saints game. This is not a Saints game we're watching here. It could be. Great ball. It is a good game. 9-2. This is for the AAA crown of the state of Louisiana for 1995. And what a great job both these coaching staffs have done. Coach Regis Pack of Cecilia and Coach Don Watney of Carr.
Sims keeps it on the option. Finds a crease. Gets inside the 35. Down to the 33.
You know, that penalty may loom very large if Carr can convert right here, because they were looking at a punting situation. They were fourth and long, and that face mask infraction gave them a new life and a new opportunity. And Sims right here breaks a tackle, holds on to the ball, gets hit a number of times. That's one thing you have to say about Cecilia. They gang tackle. There's no such thing as one man bringing a ball carrier down. They tackle in gangs and groups.
Second and short, down at the 33-yard line. Double tight end for Carr. Sims keeps it to pick up the first down. Chance out of one tackle and still motor down to the 25, down to the 24-yard line. Corey Green finally makes the stop. The Carr offense, Renee, is coming alive.
And yes, that offensive front is beginning to make some noise with Washington, Robertson, Johnson, Paletti, and Roach. And you can see Sims is just showing some great athletic moves right here. And the Carr offensive front is just taking control in the pit and opening some holes. But I'll tell you, what a tenacious defense this green jersey Cecilia Bulldog group has.
This is Carr's deepest penetration since 10 minutes in the first quarter. Now it's the Bulldog 24. Handoff counter going the far away. This Carr all the way down to the 14-yard line. Is Shannon Smith.
Actually, it's a 16-yard line. He's shy. His knee went down, so they'll put it in with a gain to the 16-yard line. But he'll be looking at a second down and short yardage for the Carr Cougars. And yes, that face mask infraction has really given them new life. You can see a good run here, giving them deep in penetration.
Full house backfield on second and short, surging straight ahead in the power game. Puncturing the 15, getting down to the 14-yard line. Was Corey Harrison, your short yardage specialist, 5'10", 210-pound senior. And the chains will move first and 10 to the Carr Cougars, down to the 14-yard line. Timeout on the field. Cecilia wants to talk about it. 9-2. Cecilia on top of Carr with 5:58 left here in the third quarter from the Louisiana Superdome. Gerald Duhon along with Renee Nato, happy to be bringing you this AAA state championship ball game. The Carr faithful on the far sideline, whooping it up, responding. And once again, Renee, we see the Carr defense setting up the Carr offense. A staunch Carr defense holding Cecilia 3-and-out on their opening drive and forcing a punt, which turned out to be a poor snap, a safety for Carr, and that defensive stand has now ignited their offense.
Well, the thing that Carr, we talked about Cecilia, the thing that Carr must do is control the ball. They only throw when they have to. They opened the game with a pass to the tight end and really haven't thrown much since that time. They've thrown a couple of times, really had one picked off. But they must run consistently, which they've really gutted it out and play hard-nosed offense. And they must have their defense allow them good field position. And one thing, their defense has not been as solid in the first half. That's Carr's defense. And it's not turned the ball over, forced Cecilia to mistakes. Cecilia has played a pretty good first half, and this is their toughest challenge that the Cecilia defense has received thus far in this contest.
Both sets of fans getting into it now. First and 10 for Carr at the Bulldogs 14. Motion right to left. Hand off on the delay. That's Harris. He's got some room inside the five. Down to the 3-yard line goes Corey Harrison. Corey Jackson and Chris Broussard make the stop, but it'll be first and goal for Carr.
And Corey Harrison, 5'11", 215 pounds. He knows what to do with the ball. He's employed as an inside linebacker, but he is the tough guy in the red zone, which is right here, and he's diving. He smells that goal, and boy, I tell you what, he will lay the lumber to you. He takes that same mentality as a linebacker and attacks the defense when he's carrying the ball.
One wide out on the left-hand side. Backs are in and out. Everybody in tight. Sims will keep it. Saved ahead. Get drilled down just short of the goal line. Second and goal. The interior of that Bulldog defense. Baptiste and Broussard and Singleton and Davis all converging to make the stop.
And what a front right here. Look at that surge. Great surge by the offensive front, particularly Robertson and Johnson and Paletti up front for the Carr Cougars. Gives them a little running room down to the 1-yard line, and second and one. Boy, I tell you, this is tough going right here.
Hand off. Second back through into the end zone for the touchdown. That was Leonard Welch. Leonard Welch coming into the ball game and turning it into the end zone. And Carr has come from 1 point in tying this ball game up with 5:07 left in the third quarter.
And that's Welch's 14th touchdown run of the 1995 campaign. He runs tough, really runs tough behind that offensive front. Dives a la Herschel Walker and gets him to the end zone. And boy, I tell you what, great job putting up the offensive front for Carr for that score.
Welch's ankle was bothering him. You couldn't tell it on that last play. Matt Dick into the extra point. Low snap. Dick kicked it up in time, and Dick is good. Late flag comes streaming down as Dick may have been roughed on that play. He was on the seat of his britches. And it's 9-9 right here. 5:07 left in the third quarter.
I would like you to notice that there's a replay that the holder dropped the ball and got it back in position in time for the extra point to be successful. This is the touchdown run right here. Leonard Welch gets the ball and just a tremendous surge running behind fullback Corey Harrison. And I tell you what, there's a lot of meat up front right there. He's just got a great alley, dives, gets airborne into the end zone and breaks that plane. And the extra point is coming here. You see, watch, number 90 drops the ball, but gets it back just in time. Does not break the place kicker's concentration or his follow-through. And I tell you what, you can credit number 90, Jimmy Ferguson, with an outstanding play with his hands and making that play successful. He dropped the ball and got it back in time to kick to make the extra point.
Roughing the kicker was the call against Cecilia, so Carr will kick off from the Cecilia 45 as the penalty will be tacked on to the ensuing kickoff.
That drive, Gerald, 9 plays going 59 yards, 4:33 off the clock. The final play was that 1-yard dive by Leonard Welch's 13th of the campaign, and in case that name rings a bell, his Uncle Robert is the head coach at BHA, which was one of the top coaches in this area. So he comes from a pretty good bloodline. Leonard Welch, only a junior. Great guy, too, Robert Welch. Yes, he is. Good coach.
Kickoff by Jesus Howell is in and out of the end zone. The youngster down there having some fun with some of the Carr players.
You know what, this kickoff, this guy, Jesus Howell, his dad, this is the first time he's watching him play. This is the first time his dad is watching him play, and his dad is in from Honduras, and he's never saw his son, Jesus, play before, and so that's a proud day for that dad and son and family. What a big, big day, a 9-9 game here in the Superdome, and what an exciting game. It's everything it was built to be.
Out comes Bayward. Jackson and I, double wide outs, left-hand side, handoff, first back through, big hole to Jermaine Davis, still spin forward to the 28, quick pickup of 8 yards, David Watkins making the stop.
And Davis can make a lot of yards on his own, But he runs behind the left side of the line, Corey Green and Parker Alamont. You can see, and also a good block right there, good block, allowing him to get into the, getting free into the secondary for a good pickup at second and two for the Bulldogs.
And off this time to Jackson, he'll pick up the first down, get across the 35, up to the 36. Chains will move for the Cecilia Bulldogs. Dwayne Lewis comes up the later wood and make the stop for Carr.
And he's taking a pounding. I tell you, every time Corey Jackson carries the ball, that wrist is really, really bothering him a great deal. And he's just trying to play on grit and guts. And you can see that right wrist is really bothering him an awful lot. He takes a hit right here from David Watkins. Gives him a first down, but Corey Jackson finds a seat on the bench.
And it'd be helped to the bench by one of the trainers. Davis surging ahead just short of the 40-yard line. Gain of two. Jackson's wrist has been bothering him since the first quarter, and when he took a shot, he's been in and out of the game ever since then.
That's a lot of pain right now, and he's playing on sheer guts, knowing that this is the last game of the 1995 season. In fact, this is the last game of his career at Cecilia.
Second and seven. Strength of the formation is to the left side. And the tight end, Robbie Chevalier, who is the credit for the strength of that side, jumps a little early. Procedure against Cecilia. Talking about careers at Cecilia, we've mentioned Jamaican D'Artes. Coming through this year with the all-time Tulane record. Rushing record for freshmen, surpassing Reggie Reginelli, and during the season, during Tulane's bye week, Jamaican, an outstanding honor. His number 19 retired in ceremonies back in Cecilia. So you will find no number 19 for the Cecilia Bulldogs on the field. Bayard wants the pass, tossing the ball deep down the field, complete on the play. Across midfield, Chris Broussard calling in that pass. A beautiful catch on that play as he ran way up in the air. Dwayne Lewis bringing him down, and Broussard hanging on to the ball. Excellent protection for quarterback Bayard as well.
Bayard with great ball-handling skills, and he delivers it right where it needs to be. Throws it right on mark to Broussard, and we mentioned Broussard tall, 6'2". He's a good cover man, a good wide receiver. He's an all-district performer as his quarterback position, and he is only a junior. He'll be back wearing the green again in 96.
Right outs left and right, backs in and eye. Five-man charge front. Hand off to fullback Davis. He'll make it down to the 42. Gain of five. Shannon Smith, an inside linebacker, closes in for the stop. This Carr Cougar team has never lost a district game in the 3 years that they've competed in District 10-3A. Started the season ranked number three, worked their way up to number one in week six. Cecilia, as we mentioned, ranked number two. There's a close shot of tailback Corey Jackson. He's been hampered tonight by a wrist injury.
Looks like it might be his elbow. Not sure. It's definitely an arm injury.
Second down, running right, Williams. Net at the 40-yard line. What a hit. Noel Ellis.
Guess what, fellas? Meet Mr. Ellis. He's and Noel Ellis, a 6'3", 210-pound product. Again, he's a basketball prospect, but a football prospect as well, and probably one of the best athletes on his team. He really, you can hear the wood crack from up here. Watch this. Williams is still going, but he's going to run it to number 44, and all of a sudden he's going in the opposite direction. You can hear the brake screeching and the glass cracking right here.
Ellis, too, last week, hurting his knee against Faraday, and it was questionable whether he'd play all week. Bayard dropping back, play action complete to D'Artes. D'Artes inside the 30, down to the 28-yard line. Excuse me, Hackworth with that reception. Phillips finally hauls down Hackworth, and on a pivotal third down, the chains will move for the Cecilia Bulldogs. Hackworth once again with another clutch catch.
That's catch number 11 of the 1995 campaign, and Hackworth, a senior, giving it his all for the final game, a 5'8", 150-pound wide receiver, flanker back, Charles Hackworth. Well, he's done a good job for the green and gold through his career. And off Davis, wrapped up, nowhere to go. Guess who? David Watkins, first one there, along with Jamal Casby as well. He's driven backwards and stopped. Now, we talked about it, most of these players. David Watkins had an ankle injury in the first quarter, but he's going to be a good stand-up linebacker on the next level. He was a 4.940, Gerald. He is being recruited hard by Tennessee, Nichols, Magnese, Tulane, and USL. He will visit the Razorbacks of Arkansas as soon as the season concludes, but he's got a great frame, 6'4", 215, can add about 20 pounds, and it makes him one an outstanding outside linebacker, defensive end.
25 seconds left in the third quarter with the clock rolling. We're tied up here, 9-9. Hayward wants the pass, play action, tosses the ball, overthrown. Cannot get to his intended receiver, Chad Gartez. Good coverage by Jerry Phillips. 15 seconds left in the third quarter. Cecilia attempting to move the ball on what Lutcher head coach Tim Dutillier called the best defense that he has ever seen in his many years coaching.
Great ball handling skills by Bayard, and look at the delivery. I mean, a great spiral. He just overshot his receiver, but Bayard, an all-district performer, with a 3.5 grade point average, so he's a pretty cerebral guy.
Bayard wants to pass again, Spanish. Overthrown, almost picked off by Noel Ellis. He had visions of goal line dancing in his Christmas wish list there.
And visions of grandeur. You see that knee brace that is hindering his mobility just a wee bit, but he's picked off 15 enemy passes throughout the 1995 campaign. Perhaps if Jimmy Ferguson not got a hand on it, Noel Ellis would have been touchdown bound, or at least would have made an interception. But Cecilia breathes new life with a 4th-and-12 situation. And they're in for a punt. And just a field goal.
A 47-yard field goal attempt from Andy Chance. To give Cecilia the lead. Good snap. Ball going. And good! It did not appear it would have the distance, but it's found its way through the uprights. And Cecilia, on the strength of a 47-yard field goal, goes ahead of Hart, 12-9, with 4 seconds left.
And Andy Chance is a guy that usually converts from 40 yards and in. Other than that, Chris Broussard comes in and kicks, but they had a lot of confidence in Andy Chance, and he converts on a 47-yard field goal. He's the all-district kicker and punter, and I tell you what a great job he did. Andy Chance, only a sophomore right here. Good control of the ball, and he really got a lot of explosion into it inside the, I tell you, he had a lot of room there, a lot of distance, and puts the Bulldogs up 12-9 in a seesaw battle here. Has come down to 4 ticks in this third stanza. Andy Chance, you'll hear a lot from that young man before his career is over for the Cecilia Bulldogs. And that drive, Gerald, 11 plays, 50 yards distance, 5 minutes and 3 seconds off the clock. The final play in that drive, a 47-yard field goal by sophomore kicker Andy Chance. As Chance prepares to kick off at his own 40-yard line, and Carr has really had not much luck offensively tonight, and the only drive they've had is the last touchdown drive of the third quarter here as we fast approach the beginning of the fourth quarter, and the final ticks. The final play will take it down to the end of the third period.
High end of the end kick. Lewis takes it. He'll run it up across the 30. That's the 31, and that is the end of the first quarter. It's Cecilia turning to a 12-9 advantage.
We'll be right back.
First and 10 for Carr. Givens operating on the right-hand side. He'll track the 30, get up to the 32-yard line. It'll be second down at 8 as Carr starts the fourth quarter, trailing by 3 to Cecilia, 12-9. And Renee, that field goal by chance, breaking a AAA record for the longest field goal here in the Superdome during the Classic. 38 yards was the previous record last year by Fabian Franklin. So we've got a brand new field goal record of 47 yards by Andy Chance.
What a big field goal that was. In fact, Carr has kind of changed things up a little bit. It's closed the gap of statistics. Cecilia in total offense, 195 to Carr's 103 for three quarters of play.
Hand off to Harrison. And the Cecilia defense is fired up. He does not get much. Jerome Wilkes making the stop.
Good shot right there of Jonah Williams. Jonah Williams, who's played both sides of the ball, stepping up this game, playing offense and defense, and done a pretty good job. And Jerome Wilkes has been that fiery leader from his mic position on the defense.
Sims being hurried in the backfield, will toss the ball downfield and underthrown his intended receiver. A late flag comes streaming in on the far side. It will be fourth down, but let's read the flag.
It's going to go against the Carr Cougars. Ineligible receiver downfield.
I'm sure that'll be declined. It could force yet another Cougar punt.
You see Sims, once he breaks contain here, he's a little dangerous, but Corey Green does keep a bead on him right here, and Jerome Wills keeps distance between he and the receiver. And it was just an incomplete pass, but you can credit Corey Green for putting pressure on Sims and Jerome Wills with positioning himself for an interception on a breakup A pass. Happy fan right there.
Having a good time making the trip down from St. Martin.
A lot of happy faces right now. 12-9, a lot of football to be played. And Carr will relinquish the ball to the Cecilia Bulldogs.
Fourth down. As Cecilia will burn a timeout and talk things over. Some alignment a little unclear. Coach Waggis back will huddle his troops and chat about it with 10:39 left in the ballgame. 12-9 Bulldogs on top of the Cougars here in the Superdome. James Waggis back leading the St. James Wildcats to a state championship back in 1979. And now he's trying to do the same with the Cecilia Bulldogs. Cecilia losing last year in the quarters to eventual state champ Amit by only 1 point, 21-20. And coincidentally, Amit also eliminating Carr last year in the regionals, 6-3. Cecilia's loss is here in the dome for state finals to Carr, well documented on this broadcast 2 years ago, 13-10 in overtime, and the year before to arch rival Jennings, 14-7. The Jennings Bulldogs over the Cecilia Bulldogs back in 92. Helmstetter receives the snap, puts a high spiraling kick. It'll be taken right at the 35-yard line by Hackworth with a fair catch. That'll be put it in play, first 10 for Cecilia. And you know, that's something that you can tell a well-coached team, they used a fair catch. You just don't see that enough in high school football, is teams using the fair catch and using it correctly. Hackworth showed very good judgment right there.
You're going to have ice water in your veins to run back punts at any level, high school, college, or professional. And a good punt return specialist is worth his weight, because he can lull the defense into thinking the ball. They have no way of knowing where the ball is coming down. So on a bad kick, he can lull the defense to sleep somewhere. Bayard will give it to Wilkes, who will struggle forward for a gain of 3.
Dwayne Lewis running up from his cornerback spot. Seeing a lot of playing time tonight with Rasheed Johnson less than 100% with a knee injury.
Corey Jackson still positioned on the bench, and that is increased playing time for Jerome Wilkes. Comes over from defense. He knows what to do with the ball. Breaks a couple of tackles right there and finally put down on a
Nice tackle by Dwayne Lewis. He's second and seven. And off to fullback Davis. He will surge forward. And not pick up much more. And Renee, you've witnessed this Cecilia defense tonight, an impressive defense, but would you believe me if I told you that they've yet to pitch a shutout this season? Of course, it's not going to happen tonight with Carr's 9 points, but you think with the type of defense that we've seen Cecilia run tonight, they would certainly have a couple of shutouts during the season. They've played exceptional defense here this evening. They just play that smash-mouth ball on both sides of the ball, and it's easy to see why they've gained this much momentum and gotten here to the Super Bowl. Toss sweep right on third and five, stringing out the play and tying up Jonah Williams is Shannon Smith. And Shannon Smith is going to be a prospect for 1996. He's a linebacker, only a junior, 4A speed. He skates to the sidelines, keeps good position between him and the runner, and explodes into Williams for the tackle. Calls for a fourth down and 3 yards to go. A punting situation for Cecilia. It may give the Carr Cougars pretty good field position. And the excited bunch there. They're glad to be here and doing an outstanding job, and they deserve to be where they are in the Superdome, playing for the finals of 3A.
Fourth and three, chances in the punt. Beautiful, spiraling kick, wow. And it takes a big Cecilia bounce, and Lewis covers it with great athleticism up around the 14-yard line. What a kick. A 45-yard punt for Chance.
What a great kick by Andy Chance. Easy for you to see why he is the all-district punter and place kicker. Andy Chance, only a sophomore. He'll be back for more great days ahead for the Cecilia Bulldogs, but good foot action. Boy, I tell you what, and that was a heck of a kick right there.
Nice spiraling action on the ball as it comes down earthward, and watch this move by Lewis.
Wow, that was difficult right there. That looks like me coming home from a hard day's work.
Hard night's play, you know.
Well,
Sims on the quarterback keeper across the 15, up to the 16. I'll tell you, if I'm Lewis, I don't want to muff that and have to come back to the bench and have to face Coach Watney.
If he does, he's on the Cecilia bus going home. But it's second and 7 yards to go, so a 3-yard pickup. But Edward Sims, this is going to be quite a challenge to the senior quarterback right here. And Welsh, Givens, and Harrison are going to have to step up a notch. The runners, the foot soldiers, if you will, for the Carr Cougars.
Backs are split behind Sims, who will keep the ball, taking matters into his own hands, surging across the 25 up to the 28-yard line. And on second and seven, Edward Sims picks up a first down before Theo Singleton can make the stop. And the chains will move for the Cougars. So after successive three and out drives for both teams, Carr puts together a first down, and they're moving from our right to our left with 7:24 left in the ball game, and the Cougars trailing by three.
Good faking brought all the attention to Corey Harrison, and Sims is allowed some freedom to dance down the field and drag a tackler or two with him for a first down for a nice pickup. He had 200 yards rushing for the 1995 season.
Sims wants the pass, harried, now dropped across the 30. Nice defensive pressure on that play. Israel Singleton coming through. Sims will squeeze 2 yards out of it. Call it second and eight.
Coach Watney, in his fifth season with the Carr Cougars, what a great job he's done. Everywhere he's done an outstanding job. And he runs that split back beer and does a little split offense, some trips, some splits, but I'll tell you, his forte is defense.
Sims rolls right, tosses the ball deep down the field, overthrown and incomplete. His intended retarget on that play was Don Brewer. Flag on the play. Andy Chance with good coverage down the field. Let's read this flag. No flag. No infraction. Sims rolling out and just paced it after he released the ball. Theo Singleton coming through. I'm sure that contributed to the throw out of bounds.
Well, he hit with the crown of the helmet. He's lucky he got away with that hit. It wasn't a violent tackle, if you will. So Sims was knocked to the ground, but it was not a penalty in the opinion. And that was a pretty good hit. Pretty good pressure by Rio Silverton.
Coming back the other way, immediately snuffed out and dropped. Tyrone Wilkes read that like an open book. Henry Brady, the tight end, slow to get up and comes to his feet. That reverse sniffed out in a loss on the play all the way back to the 25. It'll be fourth down for Carr. After a first down, their drive stalls. They're forced to punt. And that was Jay Walker trying to get back some yards for the Carr Cougars. And now they're in a punting situation with 5:55. And if Cecilia can make some noise right here with this possession, they can run this clock down to just a minute or two left in the game and not leave much time for the Carr Cougars. Helmstetter's punt, a spiraling kick that Hackworth will take in at his own 39 and advance the ball up to the 44-yard line. And that's where Cecilia will put into play, a 35-yard kick and a 6-yard return. As the offense comes back on the field for Cecilia, and we talked about those offensive front. You see number 73 right there, only a sophomore, a baby. But Parker Alamont, a 6'1", 295-pounder, he's a 3-year starter. He has been in the offensive front for 1,000-yard rushers for the last 3 years. He's being looked at closely by USL and Tulane. You mentioned his strength, 440 in the bench press.
Hand off to Davis, straight ahead, nothing doing, says the interior of the Cougar defense. No gain on the play, second and 10. The Carr defense needing to stiffen up here. Cougars have all three of their timeouts. Cecilia with but one, with 5:15 left in the ball game, and Cecilia on top of Carr, 12-9.
What an exciting game this has been. It's been everything that has built today to be coming into this game. Two powerhouses from the 3A level.
Hand off again to fullback Davis, who's getting extensive work tonight. And they surge across the 50 on an excellent second effort, make it into Carr Cougar territory.
Great leg strength on the part of Jermaine Davis, 190 pounds fullback, and as you alluded to, Gerald, he's got 824 yards. He's averaging 4.7 yards per toe, 10 touchdowns. He's used primarily as a blocker for Corey Jackson, but with Jackson on the sidelines for this game, much of the game with that wrist and elbow injury, Jermaine Davis has gotten much more attention. Third down conversions for Cecilia, 2 out of 9 on the game.
It's a big one right here, 3rd and 5. Pitch out. Williams. Penalty markers coming down. Williams well short of the first down. Carr defense stringing that one out with excellent execution. Corey Harrison applying the brakes. Shannon Ruffin helping out. Holding Cecilia.
You know, Harrison wanted to redeem himself. He broke his ankle before the 1994 playoffs began. He's a hitter, got good speed. He's being looked at as well by Northwest Louisiana, Nicholls State. But he comes up. Good linebacker instincts he possesses. Corey Harrison, number 34. You see him coming to your picture shortly here. And he puts the stops on. Good right here. Puts the stop on. Good helmet-to-helmet action. And he's helped along by Shannon Smith and a couple of his teammates. But a good stop by Corey Harrison.
Chance stands back at his own 38. Lewis and Phillips at their 10. This is a shorter effort by Chance that Phillips will run up and take it to 20, room at the 30. Look at him go. Across the 45, across midfield, dragging tackles all the way down to the 40-yard line. What an outstanding punt return by Jerry Phillips to give Carr an opportunity to either tie or go up in this ball game with 3:33 left in the contest.
And Phillips just hit that lane. You can see he saw a lane right, and he's heading right down that lane. He gave one of these Cecilia Bulldogs a ride on his back, and you can see right there that was Chad D'Artes, and they said the ball was dead. But look, he hits the lane right here. Good block by Jimmy Ferguson, and Watkins picks up a block right here as well. But a good cutback had had Chance not held him up, he was touchdown bound, and he gave Dortez a nice ride on his back.
A 38-yard punt return for Jerry Phillips. On first down.
And this is the time when the Carr Cougars are going to have to make some noise offensively. They've averaged 27 points a game offensively, so they're looking at not 9 points. You can see right here, it looks like the ball may be stripped away. It looks like it was a fumble. So I guess perhaps they've broken even. They had one ball taken away where maybe it was not a fumble, so this one was a fumble. They're 1-1.
Shannon Smith ran the ball on first down, and on second down, Corey Gibbons runs it. He goes over the right side, down to the 35.
Corey Gibbons, I tell you one thing about him, only 5'6", 155, Gerald, but great vision, good quickness, good hands, and he really reads his blocks very, very well. Sometimes the hole may not be where it's supposed to be, so he'll peel it back. But third down conversions, Carr is 0-7 on the evening, and it's 3rd and 7 right now.
Pitch out, near side, that's Jerry Phillips trying to pick his blocks and cannot. He's headed for 35 and driven backwards after a gain of 2. It'll be 4th down and at least 5, and with 2:12 and the clock running in this ball game, Carr must go for it on 4th down. Carr will talk about it as they spend one of their 3 timeouts. 2:05 left in the contest. Cecilia 12, Carr 9. Here for the AAA state championship for Louisiana Superdome.
You see Wiltz really put the big hat on him right there. Jerome Wiltz put the stop on Phillips. And that was a big tackle by 2 fine athletes. It's 4th and 5 right now, and this may be the ball game, because if Cecilia hits the ball back, they only have 2 minutes. And if they get a first down, that could be the ball game for the Bulldogs. But 12-9, a defensive struggle. It's everything you thought it would be. And you mentioned Cecilia coming in only allowing their opponents 12 points per outing. And Carr with a low 5.2 points per game to their opponents for the 1995 season, including 6 shutouts throughout the year.
This game very similar to the previous game, 13-10. This game 12-9. I'm talking, of course, of the 1993 state championship game that Carr won.
And this is what makes champions right here. This separates the contenders from the pretenders. When you can convert or hold your opponent right here, we'll find out who's got what it takes right here to be a champion.
2 undefeated 14-0 Giants scoring, 4th and 5. Sims calls for the ball. Rolls right. He may tuck it or throw it. He'll be stopped and met in the backfield and driven out of bounds. Israel Singleton flying up. And the coverage was there downfield as well. Sims had nowhere to throw it. He had to hang on to the ball, and he was driven out of bounds. The ball will go over to Cecilia on down. 1:51 left in the contest. Carr has the 2 timeouts.
Well, let me tell you what happened right here. Israel Singleton comes up from a strong safety position, puts pressure on the quarterback, but he has a nose for the ball. He's quick for the ball, and he just figured his quarterback could cover his backside. He came up, met the run, made a tremendous play, got some help right there. But you can credit Israel Singleton, only a junior, strong safety, for making one of the biggest plays of the game, maybe the biggest play of the year for the Cecilia Bulldogs. Number 80 comes into it here, and he gets some help from Corey Green, number 54, but number 80 put on the brakes on Ed Sims.
1st and 10 for Cecilia at their own 40. The object now, hold on to the ball, maintain the clock, and keep it spinning towards the Bulldogs' first state championship. 1st and 10. Quarterback Bayard bringing his troops up to the line of scrimmage. The clock is in motion. It does go in motion on change of possession in high school. Handoff on the left-hand side, fullback Davis. He won't get far. Carr immediately calling a timeout. 1:24 left in the contest. It'll be 2nd and 10. Don Watney, the end of a long nights of work for that man, and a long season of work as well for both he and his staff. A long work of
A lot of long work here for folks as well, including executive producer Wayne Griffith, producer Jamuel Starkey, director of events here Mark Kaufman, our director Walter Volpatti, graphics DJ Barrett, cameras, stage managers, and all the rest of the people that have really helped out and added to this broadcast tonight. Hard work for everyone involved, bringing you the excellent view you saw of this game.
A lot of fun. It doesn't get any better than this. So the finals in Sing Ray all the way up to 5A in 1 minute, 24 seconds. One of these teams is going to be the champion of 3A. On second down, Davis getting the call again, surging forward for one, maybe two. Carr immediately spending its last timeout, and it'll be third down. And about 7 yards with 1:19 left in the ball game. Carr cannot stop it again. They are out of timeouts. A lot of emotion right there in the stands, and that's Cecilia's side anticipating a victory for the Bulldogs as they go back home following this game, and a 3-point advantage to the Bulldogs right now, 12-9, Cecilia the Carr.
Big sign before the game on the Cecilia sideline that the cheerleaders make and the players run through. It said, unfinished business in the dome. That's what we've seen the Bulldogs are taking care of after falling to Carr here, after falling to Jennings here. Seems the third time is the charm for Coach James Ragusback, this entire Cecilia Bulldog team and the community of Cecilia as well.
And remember, this game was an emotional game for the team, for number 15, Jedediah Jones, number 15 on the back of each helmet of each Cecilia Bulldog.
Davis again surging forward to the 45. He is well short of the first down. Watch spinning in motion, 1:10 left in the ball game. So I would assume Cecilia will punt it. Carr will get their hands on the ball one more time. With very little time remaining, Jerry Phillips dropping back along with Dwayne Lewis to try to receive this punt. Of course, Phillips always very dangerous.
They're going to get the ball back with about 35 seconds remaining. And it'll be up to them to make something happen. But Cecilia may get a penalty here for delay of game, which probably wouldn't be the worst thing could happen. They're just going to let it all run out. Clock showing 35 ticks left on it and continuing to spin. They're going to let it go as far as it will go. And they'll make down to the 32nd mark. Quarter number four. That says it all right there. And now they're turning the ball over to Carr, which will only have about 28 seconds for something to happen. Of course, this punt, depending on what happens here and what kind of field position they'll get out of the punt. But Andy Chance, remember, what kind of, he had a 45-yard boot last time down, and he's an all-district punter and place kicker.
Remember the last time that Jerry Phillips returned the ball? It was a 38-yard return, and he was just one player from breaking it all the way. Phillips returning a first quarter interception into the end zone, which was called back because of a blocking infraction. Carr coming on the punt, partially blocking the ball, and it's going to bound out of bounds, take a big Cecilia roll, and end up going out of bounds at the 36. I don't know if that block doesn't work to Cecilia's advantage, because you've got Carr in not the best field position at their own 36, but it keeps the ball out of the hands of Jerry Phillips. A 24-yard kick, which is not bad considering the block.
And you knock 6 seconds off the clock as well. So, yes, that was an advantage. And you can't do a lot of damage with 24 seconds. They're going to have to air it out. It's not been the forte of the Carr offense. It's not a throwing team. They only throw to set up that run at times and to keep the defense honest. So, this is a team that doesn't find themselves trailing very often and don't need to throw the ball very often as well.
Carr in need of heroics like they found against John Eric. Edwin Sims scrambled 18 yards for the winning score with the 20 seconds left in that ball game that came in week five. Sims drops back to pass, tossing the ball deep downfield, wide open. There's a couple of Carr receivers, and did it come down? No, incomplete. Two receivers were wide open. There was just a little too much air under the ball as it fell incomplete right around the 28-yard line. Chris Broussard, good coverage there.
Well, it's highly unlikely they'll kick a field goal from this position, I'll tell you that. What would that be? About 150-yard field goal or something like that?
I don't think Dempsey could kick that one.
Yeah.
Jerry Phillips, the intended receiver. And you can see the Tartugos trying to work some of these outstanding players into their offense.
Split out on the right-hand side is fifth basketball players, Royal and Noel. Ellis. Sims will heave it down once again, deep down the field, jump ball around the 28. Incomplete one more time. Chris Broussard coming down with the ball. And there's 8 seconds left in the ball game. Carr will have one more shot to leave it down the field and possibly with a completion. If the ball would get out of bounds, the Cougars would have enough time to attempt the long field goal. All you got is an alley-oop situation here, airing it deep, trying to get it to Noel Ellis or perhaps Phillipson. A good play, real good play by Broussard, saves the day once again. And Chris Broussard, once again, his athletic talents earned him all district honors as cornerback. And he'll be he's a junior. He'll be back for 1996 season. 8 seconds left. Carl with the ball at their own 36. Sims will roll right again. Toss the ball in the flat this time. Ellis has it. And he gets out of bounds with 1 second left in the ball game. It is not over. There's 1 second left in the ball game as Ellis skedaddles out of bounds just short at the 47-yard line. First down for Carr. It was 3rd and 10. So the Cougars will have one chance left. Ellis expected a little hook and lateral or some type of pitch out right there, but Ellis ran the ball towards the sideline and got out with 1 second left. I was expecting Tony Nathan to come around from the Miami Dolphins and take that pitch as something to play that Miami Dolphins used to their use successfully a few years back. But this is the last gasp for the Carr Cougars. And 1 second left. This is definitely the final play of the 1995 season for both of these teams. Flag coming in. Six Cecilia Bulldog defenders are at least 20 yards down the field. Four of them are inside the 20, another two inside the 30. They only have five people around the ball. They're going to rush four. They have a linebacker that's hanging around 10 yards off the line of scrimmage. Illegal procedure against Carr. That'll make the task 5 yards more daunting. It'll be back to the 42-yard line. Coach Don Watney, not even looking, squatting down on the far sideline. And Noel Ellis is the quarterback for this last play. He'll throw it for all he's worth down the sidelines. Looking for Jerry Phillips. Incomplete. Cecilia is your state champion. The AAA state championship goes to the Cecilia Bulldogs. Tried once against James, twice against Carr. The third shot against the Carr Cougars is the key. Congratulations to Coach James Ragusak. Win number 76 in his 9-year Cecilia career is the sweetest. It brings the state championship trophy to the LHSAA back home to St. Martin and to Cecilia. What a happy bunch they are in the stands right below us. And the green and red Cecilia Bulldogs. And you see it good, got a good looking Joe Dragon back there. That team has earned this time. 12-9 playing this outstanding Carr team that was rated number one in the state for most of the season, if not all of it. And the Carr Cougars go home with their first loss of the season, but what an outstanding year they've had finishing up here in the finals.
Everything you expect from number one against number two. What an outstanding contest.
Not much can be said. What an emotional feel there is down on the field after a game like this. And the Carr Cougars, their faces say it all. But they have dominated the state in AAA throughout the 1995 campaign. And they've beaten everyone they've played against. They have not shied away from any competition at all. And they've really, really had an outstanding season. The Cecilia Bulldogs triumphant with a 12-9 victory here at the finale here at the Superdome tonight. And they have earned that victory with just outstanding play defensively. This was termed to be a defensive shootout, Gerald, and that's exactly what it was.
Well, credit Cecilia. They came in here with an excellent game plan, executed it, made the plays they had to when Carr was picking up the momentum in the second half.
Carr picked up the safety, picked up the touchdown. With 5:07 left in the third quarter, it was a tie game, but back would come Cecilia, an 11-play, 50-yard drive that took 5:03 off the clock. Chance hitting a 47-yard field goal, and that was all the scoring with a quarter still to be played.
And some happiness, emotion going through this crowd, and you just can't, you can't top anything like this. Prep football, it's such a big thing down here, and I tell you, it's a happy event for the Cecilia crowd that ventured down here to the Superdome and are glad they did. A lot of smiles, a lot of happy faces, a lot of emotion. A lot has gone into the season for both of these teams, and once again, the Cecilia Bulldogs probably didn't think they'd find themselves in this position
for the season. Of the playing field for the presentation of awards.
Getting ready for
please clear the center
awards down at the field, something Cecilia has waited an awful long time for. Many trips to the dome these fans have made and
finished. And it's Louisiana Aiken, the sponsoring tonight, state championship trophy, an individual player award. Buckley of New Orleans, State Farm Agent Sal Bordley of West Bank, State Farm Agent Frank Alexander of La Place, and State Farm Agent Bruce Montesano of Bro Bridge. And now, the first award presented by State Farm Agent Sal Bordley of the West Bank in New Orleans goes to the runner-up outstanding player award goes to number 12, Edward Sims of Edna Carr High School.
Turn around this way.
The next award presented by State Farm Agent Ab Flint of Metairie is the 1993 Class 3A State Farm Runner-Up Championship Trophy goes to Edna Carr High School. Head coach Don Waddingly, Principal John Heiser. The next award is the 1995 Biden Official Game Ball. Biden is the official ball of the LHSA. The award is being presented tonight by Mr. Dick Schindler, Assistant Director of the National Federation of State High School Athletic Associations, goes to Cecilia Head Coach Jimmy Wagenspack. The next award is the State Farm Outstanding Player to Cecilia, presented by State Farm Agent Frank Alexander of La Place, goes to number 11, Andrew King. The final award presented by State Farm Agent Bruce Montesano of Bro Bridge goes to the 1995 AAA State Champion Cecilia Bulldogs. Head coach Jimmy Wagenspack, Principal Malcolm Kelly. For sponsoring all LHSA state championship trophies and awards. The LHSA also thanks Gatorade, title sponsor of the 1995 Gatorade Superdome Classic. The LHSA thanks Biden, the official ball of the LHSA. Thanks to Coca-Cola for sponsoring high school athletics, and Sports Care of Louisiana for providing trainers for all LHSA state championship events. Good night, everyone, from the LHSA.
Hot boudin, cold couscous. Come on, Cajuns, push, push, push. Cecilia taking their first state title by a 12-9 count. Andy Chance, a 47-yard field goal in the third quarter. That's a LHSA dome record for the longest field goal in a AAA state championship game. Coming here tonight, that's the winning margin. Andy Chance getting the nod for the MVP here tonight.
Yeah, and I think he deserved it. He's only a sophomore. He's an all-district performer as a place kicker, and his foot was very, very important tonight with that 47-yard field goal. His punting was outstanding as well. And if you look at what they have done, Cecilia with 214 yards in total offense to 128 for the Carr Cougars. This was billed to be a defensive struggle. That's exactly what it was, a defensive game. 12-9, Cecilia Bulldogs are the crowned champions of 3A.
And, of course, Cecilia's big contribution tonight, one of them coming from Jermaine Davis, the fullback stepping up. Corey Jackson, injured arm throughout the game, in and out of the ball game. Davis picking up the slack, coming in, doing a fantastic job for his squad, keeping the ball moving. Senior quarterback leadership and a team that's experienced and just felt like it's been here before, finally, on the third opportunity, kicking the door down, and James Waggis back as one happy head coach tonight.
Well, yes, and they've earned this game, and as far as time of possession, the game was as close as the score. Cecilia having the ball for 27 minutes, and Carr with just 20 minutes. And as far as offensive plays, Cecilia 53 offensive plays, Carr only 41. But it was close, and the score 12-9. What an exciting game. It was everything it was billed to be and more.
And then some. Credit Cecilia for taking the momentum from Carr in the third quarter and converting it into a victory. Their defense holding the Carr Cougars out of their end zone as well. Well, fantastic ball game here tonight. Congratulations to Cecilia. Their first state title coming tonight by the score of 12-9. Andy Chance, the 47-yard field goal, the game winner here from the Louisiana Superdome. 1995 for AAA is all done. I'm Gerald Duhon for Renee Nadeau. Thanks so much, and so long until next time.